So today we will discuss a very important topic, that is the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. This system operates in our body whenever our blood pressure goes down, and we know that blood pressure is very important for maintaining the blood circulation. And if the blood pressure goes down, there is the risk of shock and the patient can die. So this system operates whenever the BP will fall down. So this system operates to raise the blood pressure. We will take an example and then we see how this system operates. Suppose this is a guy and this guy meets a road traffic accident, and in the road traffic accident he get his leg injured and he start bleeding from the leg. And if he's bleeding from the leg, his BP starts to go down, and when his BP starts falling down, the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone get activated in his body, and this system starts with the kidney. As the BP goes down, there is a reduced blood flow to the kidney. Once the blood flow to the kidney is reduced, there is a release of one enzyme known as the renin, which is released from the kidney. And we will now see how the renin is released, from which part of the kidney the renin is released. This is the diagram of juxtaglomerular apparatus. This is a diagram of juxtaglomerular apparatus. From here the renin is released. Juxtaglomerular apparatus comprising of macula densa cells of distal tubule and juxtaglomerular cells of afferent arteriole. Afferent arteriole responds to the low blood pressure, and macula densa cell responds to the low sodium level. And this juxtaglomerular apparatus releases the renin. This renin, which is the enzyme, is released from the juxtaglomerular apparatus. And once the renin is released, it goes into the circulation, and in the circulation there is one protein which is being released by the liver, known as the angiotensinogen. This protein being released by the liver, known as the angiotensinogen, the renin acts on the angiotensinogen and converts it into the angiotensin 1. Once the angiotensin 1 is formed, angiotensin 1 moves in the circulation, and in the circulation it goes to the lung. And in the lung there is one enzyme known as the angiotensin converting enzyme. This enzyme converts the angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2. Now once the angiotensin 2 is formed, angiotensin 2 acts on various tissues, and it acts on various tissue to raise the blood pressure. We will see on various tissues what are the action. It acts on the adrenal cortex, it also acts on the kidney, it acts on the heart, it acts on the brain, and it acts on the blood vessel also. And in these organs they act to raise the blood pressure. So angiotensin 2 acts on these organs to raise the blood pressure. What it does to the adrenal gland is present on the top of the kidney, and in the adrenal gland there is one layer known as the zona glomerulosa, and in the zona glomerulosa it releases the aldosterone. It causes the release of aldosterone. Once the aldosterone is released, we know that aldosterone goes to the collecting duct of the kidney, and in the kidney, in the collecting duct, it causes the release of sodium and water reabsorption. Once the sodium and water is reabsorbed, the blood volume will increase. And in response to the sodium and water reabsorption, it will cause the loss of hydrogen and potassium. So once the sodium and water is reabsorbed, the blood volume will increase. We will see how the increased blood volume will increase the BP later on. Now, on the meanwhile, you remember that it will cause the aldosterone secretion and increases the sodium and water reabsorption from the kidney. Now, angiotensin 2 also acts on the kidney, and in the kidney, it again causes the sodium and water reabsorption from the distal convoluted tubule. Sodium and water reabsorption increases. And in the heart, acutely it does not have any action, but if it is chronically present, it can cause muscle hypertrophy and fibrosis in the heart. So this can lead to the cardiac remodeling, and it increases the risk of heart failure. So if fibrosis occur in the heart, there is a risk of heart failure. And this angiotensin 2 acts when it action is present chronically, only then there is a risk of heart failure. Then in the brain, it increases the sympathetic outflow. And once the sympathetic outflow will increase, and it will again act on the heart, and in the heart it will increase the heart rate. So it will increase the heart rate. In the heart, it will increase the heart rate. By increasing the sympathetic outflow, it will causes also the renin release from the kidney. From the kidney, it will release the renin. So once the renin is released, and we know that again angiotensin II will form. Now in the blood vessel, it will causes the vasoconstriction of the blood vessel. So when the blood vessel gets constricted, there is an increase of total peripheral resistance. Now we will see all these mechanism, how these will increase the blood pressure now. So we know that the blood pressure is equals to cardiac output and total peripheral resistance. And we also know that cardiac output is equals to stroke volume into heart rate. So we will see how the blood pressure will increase now. Since this by acting on the adrenal gland, it will causes the aldosterone secretion. So once the aldosterone is increases, it will ultimately increases the blood volume. So if the blood volume will increase, and we know that blood volume will increase the preload, and increased preload will increase the stroke volume. That is, the more blood come into the ventricle, because the blood is more in the circulation, so more blood will go to the ventricle and the stroke volume will increase. So once the stroke volume will increase, the cardiac output will also increase, as shown here. So once the cardiac output will increase, the BP will increase. This is how the angiotensin II acts on his adrenal gland to raise the blood pressure. Now again, similar mechanism operates in the kidney, where it was reabsorbing the sodium and water. It will again increase the stroke volume, and again the BP will increase. Now the action on the heart is by increasing the heart rate, and once the angiotensin II increasing the heart rate by stimulating the brain, that is sympathetic outflow from the brain is increased, the heart rate will increase, and once the heart rate will increase, the cardiac output will increase, and once the cardiac output will increase, the BP will increase, as shown here. Now the renin release, again the same process will happen here. Now in the blood vessel, it will increase the total peripheral resistance. So once the total peripheral resistance is increased, then we know that BP is equals to the cardiac output to total peripheral resistance. So the total peripheral resistance is increased, the BP will increase. So in this way, in his body, once the renin is released, the angiotensin II production will increase. The angiotensin II production causes act on various tissues in his body. In his body, the various tissues, the angiotensin II will act on the kidney, on the adrenal gland, on there is sympathetic outflow increase from the brain, and its heart gets stimulated, and its blood vessel gets constricted. Ultimately, this will increase the blood pressure in his body, and in this way, he can survive the death. So it is acutely, it is very beneficial. But if it is chronically present, then it can cause the heart failure. It can cause fibrosis in the heart. And once the fibrosis set in, it can lead to the heart failure and death. So it is not good for chronically. Acutely, it is very good. Now we will can also see certain drugs that are acting on various steps of this to reduce the blood pressure. For example, if renin is released from the kidney, it can be blocked by a drug known as the aliskirin. Aliskirin blocks the renin, and if renin gets blocked, the angiotensin II will not form and its action will not be there. Also, there is angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. They come with captopril. The name ends with pril. For example, the captopril. These drugs inhibit the enzyme angiotensin converting enzyme, and they won't allow conversion of angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2. And once the angiotensin II will form, it will act on the various receptors in their target organs. And these receptors are being blocked by the angiotensin converting enzymes. And they will come with the name of, for example, valsartan. Their name ends with sartan. So these are the angiotensin receptor blocker. So this is how this renin angiotensin aldosterone operates in our body whenever the BP goes down. Thank you.